This video is part of my complete practical CCNA course where I teach you how to configure and troubleshoot networks using real equipment. In this video, I'm going to show you how to download and install Cisco Packet Tracer on a Mac. In a previous video, I showed you how to install Packet Tracer on a Windows device. So if you're not using macOS, please have a look at one of the other videos where I show you how to install Packet Tracer on Windows or Linux. This video is specifically for macOS, so you can skip it if you're not using macOS. Why do you want to use Cisco Packet Tracer? Many reasons. First reason is it's free. You can register for a free course on the Cisco NetAcad website and then download Cisco Packet Tracer and use it. You need to know how to configure and troubleshoot network devices for the CCNA exam. So in the CCNA exam, they're going to give you simulation type questions. You're going to have to configure devices. These are actually Cisco virtual iOS devices, so very close to the real thing. You're going to have to configure those devices. For instance, you might have to configure something like DHCP snooping or dynamic op inspection or something else. You're going to have to configure or troubleshoot network devices in the CCNA exam. So it's really important that you get hands-on practice. Now that's for the CCNA exam, but also for the real world. I mean, you are doing the CCNA for a reason. One of those reasons is to be able to go out there into the real world and do the job. So you need to know how to configure devices such as routers and switches and so forth for the exam, but also for the real world. Now, another reason is there's no better way to learn networking than to get your hands dirty and just do it. You're going to learn so much more by configuring network devices rather than just watching me do it. Now, I've spent a lot of money buying physical devices. There are disadvantages to using Packet Tracer. As an example, it doesn't simulate devices exactly. It's a simulation. It's not a real device. It's not an emulator. It's just trying to mimic what real devices do. So there are limitations to using Cisco Packet Tracer. Now, if you can afford to buy network devices, that's great. You'll learn a lot by, for instance, converting your home network to a Cisco network. You'll make mistakes, for instance, with cabling. You'll make mistakes as you go along, and you'll learn so much by doing stuff physically. But if you can't afford to buy physical devices, don't worry. I've spent thousands of dollars doing that so that you don't have to spend that kind of money to pass the CCNA exam. Download Cisco Packet Tracer, use it, configure virtual networks using Cisco Packet Tracer directly on your laptop, and it'll help you immensely. Spend the time configuring and troubleshooting network devices using Cisco Packet Tracer. Now, there are other options out there like CML, but in this course, we're going to use Cisco Packet Tracer. It's free. It's easy to download and install. Very simple installation, which I'm going to show you now. You can configure all types of networks using Cisco Packet Tracer. Another massive advantage to Cisco Packet Tracer, it has what's called simulation mode, where you can actually see how packets flow through a network. Simulation mode will really help you with your understanding of how networks work. Another big reason to use Cisco Packet Tracer, and this is a question that comes up all the time, is it enough to pass the CCNA exam? And the answer is yes. If you spend the time in Cisco Packet Tracer configuring, troubleshooting network devices, going through the labs that are part of this course, it's enough to prepare you for the CCNA exam. Now, to download Cisco Packet Tracer, you can simply search for download Cisco Packet Tracer in Google. My first hit is what is Cisco Packet Tracer? That takes you to the NetAcad website. You can also go directly to netacad.com, click explore, select Cisco Packet Tracer, and then select getting started with Cisco Packet Tracer. So you can either go to this course or you can go to netacad/Cisco Packet Tracer and then select getting started with Cisco Packet Tracer. That takes you to an option where you can join a free self-paced course, which then allows you to download Cisco Packet Tracer. I've added a link, depending on where you're watching this below or as part of this course, where you can go directly to the download link for Cisco Packet Tracer, but you will need to register to be able to download the software. It's free, but it's well worth your time registering for Packet Tracer and using it as part of this course. You'll learn so much more. Okay, so you can either log in or you can sign up for an account if you haven't registered before. So let's assume that I haven't signed up. So if you're signing up, you'll have to select your country. So in my case, it's the UK. You have to specify your state. You have to specify your birth and month of birth and then click continue. You have to specify your first name and your last name and then your email address. Specify a password, confirm your password and click create account. Okay, so you need to read through the terms and conditions. So scroll down, read through those and then select I have read and agreed to the terms and conditions. You can receive communications if you like. I'm not going to do that. I'm simply going to click accept and continue. And there you go. I've been enrolled in the course. It's as simple as that. Now, please note, you have to use a valid email address. They are going to email you and you have to confirm your registration. Okay, so on my email, I'm going to select activate account and then click here to proceed. And there you go. My account has been updated. So again, you have to activate your account to be able to use Cisco Packet Tracer, but it is free. Now on the left-hand side, and this is the important part, download Cisco Packet Tracer. And here's a link to download the software. So I've added this link to the course, so you can go directly to Netacad Resources Lab Downloads. But please be aware that you need to register or log in to get access to the software. So I'm going to scroll down. And as you can see here, you can download various versions of Cisco Packet Tracer. Simply download the latest release of the software. So at the time of this recording, for macOS, it's 8.2.2. When you watch this video, it could be a later release. Simply download the latest release of Cisco Packet Tracer. So as you can see there, it's downloading. So I'll go to the directory and double click on the DMG file. I'll open the DMG file. As always, whenever you download software from the internet, you need to make sure that you're okay doing this. This is from Cisco, so it's reputable. So I'm going to click open, but you'd have to make that decision for yourself. And I'm going to click continue, click install, put in my username and password. The software is now being installed. Okay, so installation is finished, so I'll click done. Now, when Cisco Packet Tracer starts up for the first time, you're going to need to log in. You have to be authenticated. Hence, you have to use a valid email address. You have two options. You can select the Networking Academy or Skills for All. In the old days, the Skills for All website was a separate website, but that now redirects to the Netacad website. So I'll select Network Acad, have to put in my email address, put in my password and click login. We're authenticated and hopefully this will work. I've had problems with this in the past. I'm getting a 404 error here, so that doesn't really help us. That should authenticate our account, but it doesn't here. So what I recommend you do is use the Skills for All website, but what you might want to do is select keep me logged in for 3 months so that you don't have to keep logging in. Don't do this on a public or shared computer, but what I'll do here is select Skills for All. What that does is it opens up a web browser, and now I need to log in again. So I'll put in my username and password, click login. And notice we told you have successfully logged into Cisco Packet Tracer. You can close this tab. So now I can log into Cisco Packet Tracer. So if you have issues with the Netacad website, use Skills for All. It's going to redirect you to the same website. But at this point, I've now shown you how to download and install Cisco Packet Tracer and authenticate it so that you can use the software. In the next video, I'll show you a whole bunch of options in Cisco Packet Tracer, such as how you select routers, switches, hubs, and how you build topologies. Once again, Cisco have their own Cisco Packet Tracer course that shows you in a lot of detail how to use Cisco Packet Tracer. I'm not going to cover all the options. I'm simply going to show you how to get topologies up and running within Cisco Packet Tracer so that you can complete the labs that are part of this course.